Game lab number 10. Here we go. Draw loop again, but this time with sprites. And you'll have an option. You could pull something out of the library, or you can make your own sprite if you want to. That's up to you. Just two separate short programs today. And there's just a couple of things I want you to be thinking about when you're using sprites and the draw loop together. So that's what this assignment is about. It's not a big fancy thing, but there's a couple of things I want you to consider. So it's two short programs, draw loop in every program, sprites in every program, which again, you could get from the library or draw your own, or you could even try upload an image if you want. Random numbers, again, today. Let's throw some random numbers into these two programs. All right, so let's get over here and go to work. I'm going to have to open up a tab and get to code.org. And sorry, I'm going to have to sign in, but it'll just take a second. I didn't do that ahead of time. And we're in. All right. So I'm just going to go over to Create Game Lab, and we'll just go to work. We're going to keep that draw loop in here today. We're going to go over to the Animation tab and hit the plus button and then pick something. I am going to use a polar bear, I think. This polar bear right here, this cartoony-looking polar bear, that's what I'm going to use. And so he's called Polar Bear 1. This is my first program, right? So I'll go back over to the code side. Now, here's one thing that you've got to grab onto about working with sprites and working with the draw loop. You know, I think that you've learned that when we're working with sprites, you have to use this create sprite and this set animation block, because what that does is kind of just tells the computer, okay, I want to have this object in my program, and I want this object, it's got a name, and I want it to look like this. And so these two commands, this create sprites and this set animation, are going to go before the draw loop, because they're one-time jobs. You don't need to do that over and over, because again, and I'm just going to call this bear, and I'll leave it, that's the X and the Y, I'll just leave it at 200 200, and I'll change this to match, that'll be bear, and I want this to look like that polar bear that I had. And again, if I were doing an English translation of this, it would be, all right, I want to have an object called bear in my program. I want this object to be located at over 200, down 200. I want this bear that I've said that I want in my program to look like that polar bear that I just found in the library. So that's kind of an English translation of all of this stuff here. All right, now inside the draw loop, and I could do some other things outside, which in my next program I'll kind of show you, I will. But inside the draw loop, now I'm going to go ahead and do a few other things. Like I'm going to throw in a background color, and I think I'll just do a light green this time. I like light colors in my background. And I am going to, we have to incorporate some random numbers. We're trying to kind of animate these objects a little bit. So what I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to use a sprite.rotation. And you could try other things. You could try all kinds of stuff if you wish. But I'm just going to try a sprite.rotation. And that's going to have to be bear, because I have to stay consistent with the name of the object. And then this is where I'm going to bring in my random number. Now, random numbers work on the concept of, rotations work on the concept of degrees in a circle, 0 to 360. So I think that's good. Maybe, you could try whatever you want here, but I'm going to rotate it. And actually, what I think I might do on the limits of the rotation is to say minus 90 would be rotated to the left counterclockwise 90 degrees, and 90, which would be rotated to the right or clockwise 90 degrees. So I'm not using the whole 360 degrees that are in a circle. I'm just kind of using, you know, sort of half of it. If you think it through, there's 180 degrees involved there. So that's what I'm going to set mine up. Now, I'm using a sprite, so you know what I have to have. Draw sprites. It has to be in there. And put it inside the draw loop, not outside the draw loop. Because if that's sitting, I know I've always said that the draw sprites command has to be at the very bottom. But if it's at the very bottom outside the draw loop, it'll never happen. So it's got to be at the bottom of the list that is inside the draw loop. So see, this is not a long program. I've defined my sprite. I've got my loop in here. I've got a background. I've got this little random rotation happening. We'll see what it looks like, and then I draw sprites. All right, I'm going to run that. And he's just a jittery, he's had too much coffee or something. I don't know. He's just a jittery, kind of randomly rotating bear. Now, I have had people ask, can you slow it down at all? Well, let me show you the only way that I'm really, I've not been very effective with figuring out other ways, but over here in the world drawer, if you look, if you go click on world, there is way down kind of toward the bottom, there's one called world.framerate. And if you want to play with it, you could. The frame rate is how many frames per second the animation runs on. And by default, I'm pretty sure it runs at 30 frames per second. And if you're going to use this, you could bring it over and put it at the very top. You can set the frame rate for, well, I guess you could play around with it and do a lot of different things, but I'm just going to set it at the very top and just set it for, like if I set it for 10 frames per second. And then if I run that program, you'll see it does look different. It's kind of choppy, but I slowed it down some by changing the frame rate of the animation. Now, if I pull that out, it's going to go back to its old default value. If I reset and run, it's going to go back to its old default value of like 30 frames per second. Again, I'm pretty sure is what it runs on if you don't specify. But you could play with that frame rate thing if you want to. That is not a required part of it. So here what I have is kind of a randomly jittery rotating bear. All right, so I'm going to hit reset and I'm going to rename that, and I'll just call that Sprite Loop 1. All right. And again, if you wanted to, you could remix. Do it however it makes sense to you. You could remix this program and then change it up and do your second. You have to do two. I just want some variety. I want you to think. That's what I'm trying to have you do. I'm just going to do this. I'm just going to do Create Game Lab because, again, I feel like it's not that hard to just start from. These are not long programs. If it was a big, long program, I'd remix it, but it's not a big, long program. I'll go over to the Animation tab. I'm going to click New. And again, I'm just going to pull something from the library here. And I think I'm going to go for these germs. Look at these germs. Ooh, let's get a germ. Very appropriate. I'll take this guy right here, and I'm going to shorten that name. That name is kind of a long name, so I'll just call him Germ 1. All right, so there we go. I found a germ. I'll go back over to code. All right, now let's look at, you know, just kind of a different possibility, a different way to do it. Once again, like I told you, I have to tell the program, I have to tell the computer that I got to do this create sprite and set animation. I got to get it all set up before the draw loop. So I'm going to bring that over, and I'm going to bring that over. And by the way, if you wanted to, could you write a program here that had two or three different sprites in it doing things at the same time? Well, sure. Not required today, but you could if you want to, if you're feeling it. If you're feeling it, go for it. All right, so I'm just going to call this germ. And again, English translation. I'm telling the computer I want an object, and I'm going to name it germ. So I want that in my program, and its location for now, I'm going to change this in a minute, you'll see. But for its location for now is okay with me, 200, 200, that's X and Y. And this will be germ. I want this thing that I have named germ to look like that germ that I found over there in the library. All right. This time, inside the draw loop, I am not going to put a background command in there. And I think we saw in the previous lesson, we saw what that will do if I don't have a background command. So I'm not going to do that. But I am going to do this. I'm going to try this before I even get into the draw loop. I'm going to bring over a scale. And I'm going to say germ.scale. And I haven't really tried this yet. So this is going to be a little bit of a guess. But I think I want to scale him down some. All right, I'm going to do a decimal there. I want him to be a little bit smaller than what he normally is. And I guess it's, I don't know, if I want the germ to be a little bit smaller than what the germ normally is. So I'm going to say 0.3. That would be 3/10 of its actual size. All right, now, no background command this time. But what I am going to do is use a, in the sprites drawer here, I'm going to use a .x and a .y, a sprite.x and a sprite.y. And so I'll just bring those both over. And it's going to have to say germ. That's the name of my object, so I have to use that. And then this is where my random numbers are going to come in. So I'll just go to the math drawer, and I'll bring in my random numbers here. And this is for X and Y. So I think what I'm going to do, and you could try different things, but since I would kind of like to distribute these germs all over the whole screen in a random manner, I'm going to put in coordinates that would cover the whole screen, which would be 0 and 400 for those random numbers. Could be as low as 0, could be as high as 400. So again, just thinking through what I did here. I have defined my object right up here. I created it and I set it to look like that germ, and I scaled it before I ever got to the draw loop. Those are one-time jobs. They do not need to be done over and over. They don't need to be done again. They're only one-time jobs. Then here, I've got my X and my Y set up, and that's what's going to make it random, and it's what's going to make something happen that you'll see in a minute. The only thing I need to add now is draw sprites. That has to be in there because I am working with sprites. And so if you don't have a draw sprites command, you're not going to get any result, any action. Well, let's run that. And there he goes. It's an infestation. The germ is taking over the world. So I'm going to reset that real quick. And just because I want to play around with it a little bit, I want to see what would happen if I reduce that scale to 0.1. And now the germs are a little smaller. Now, you know, if I did want a background, I could do this. I said I wasn't going to put a background command in, but I certainly could slip a background above the draw loop and say, well, let's try a black background with that. And I'll run that. And so now my germs are on a black background, but they're not getting erased every time because the background command is not inside the draw loop. So we have an infestation of little blue germs all over the screen. All right. So, you know, a big part of this whole lesson, working through this, not a hard thing, I don't think, but when you are using the draw loop to perform some operations over and over, one of the operations that you do not have to perform over and over is this create sprite and this set animation. And in some cases, could be things like scale that don't have to be done over and over. They just need to be done once. And so if that's the case, put them outside of the draw loop, put them before the draw loop so they get done ahead of time, one time, and then all the things that you want to have happen over and over and over and over, put those inside the draw loop. So that's, you know, kind of part of the thing that I'm hoping you're grabbing and learning today is that there are occasions where commands can be outside the draw loop, and that's totally fine. All right. So it is your turn. Two programs, right? I showed you my, I should rename this and call it Sprite Loop 2 or some similar thing there. And then I would have to take my little nervously rotating bear and my infestation of germs, and I would have to turn those in on Google Classroom. Two links. Going to be looking for two programs today. All right, off you go.